I'm off up to Jim's to go to the old Jack's Hill cafe this morning. It's about 9:45 at the moment. He wants us to meet him up his at 10, so go there and have a cup of tea. I haven't done many videos lately because I've been building a greenhouse, like a designer type of greenhouse for her indoors. She wanted this greenhouse, half shed, half greenhouse thingamajig. So I've been building that really. I'll show you that at the end of the video of the construction and what I've built. I have to thank Jim for the perspex, the clear perspex roof. He had this massive sheet of 10mm clear perspex, which I used for the roof and the air vent, which is a godsend really, because that would have cost a fortune. I like to put a big thick roof on like that, because the greenhouse is pretty much underneath the underneath the trees, so if I use proper glass and and some branches fell on, I don't want to glass all over the place. It's a nice big heavy duty perspex roof on it. Yeah, I bought the framework for it, the wood for the framework, about 3 years ago. It's taken me this long to build it, because where the greenhouse is, I used to have me garden spray booth. That's where me used to do all me spraying the tanks and everything. So don't know what to do about that now, really. Just gonna have to spray the stuff out on the lawn now under a cover or something, an old gazebo or something. I'll have to get. Cross that bridge when we get to it. Yeah, it took me longer clearing the area up to put the greenhouse in than it did to build the greenhouse. And it took me like less than a week to build the greenhouse, but it took me about 3 months to clean the mess up. It's all good though. Put my plants in there, got some seeds and that growing in there now. Fruit and veg. Or veg and flowers. Go and find Jim. We got a new song on the go as well. It's a reggae song, this one. It's about the when you're a kid waiting for the ice cream man. All about that, if you know what I mean. Anyone that's remembers that, the old Tony Bell or whatever it is, Mr. Softy coming up the road and you're waiting outside your house on the curb and all that, getting your mum and dad to buy your ice creams. Who remembers a witch's hat, which was basically a, if I can remember, I think it was like two ice cream cones, one stuck on top of the other. It's called a witch's hat. 99 with the old flake. Doug come out and the mate come out of him the other day. He goes, do you remember the oysters? Yeah, I had to change some lyrics a little bit though, because it started turning into like a Judge Dredd song where he's talking about getting a big whopper and all this kind of stuff. But should have carried on with that route, I think. Probably been more of a, maybe we'd do a ska version of an ice cream man that wants to give you his big whopper. Something else in the pipeline, maybe. I'm glad I put this black coat on, this black jacket, brown leather jacket. Get too much draft up the sleeves, my arms would be bloody freezing there if I'd worn that. It's the Suzuki Tempter that we done the other week, the other month. Be following him off on that. Or mine following him. Him driving that. Well, I'll be back in a minute. Can't hear this. Jim's got my old pea shooters on that I used to have on this Triumph. That's really loud. You can probably hear it. A louder on that than they would be on the Triumph. there was a dead animal there on the side of the road there, but it's a bag. I'm in an iron this morning, which bike to come out on, whether I should come out on a Triumph, come out on the XS 650 bits of bike, or the XJ 750. This is the only one that had a full tank of petrol, so. Dave! Let go of me! go forward a bit. See ya. Hello, Dave. we're heading back home now, and time for a nice cup of tea, something to eat. Quite a good little ride out today. So until the next one, thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.